This is News Talk ZB Breaking News.
Well, some very clear messages from Civil Defence this evening. If you feel unsafe, you should leave your home immediately. And police are asking motorists near the Port Hills to not stop to have a look at the fires. There are emergency personnel that need to access the roads and you are making it difficult for them.
This is a News Talk ZB developing story.
We are taking you right across the fires today, burning on the Port Hills. We've just got off the phone to the Selwyn District Council Principal Rural Fire Officer. He says the conditions are looking much better today. It was a remarkable sight across Christchurch, wasn't it? Fire Service Southern Communication Shift Manager Lynn Crossan says the blaze really did a remarkable job in lighting up the night sky last night.
It's very visual across Christchurch at the moment, but we do have crews up there. Houses have been evacuated from both areas, but it's just a matter of hitting it again in the morning and trying to get right on top of it.
Indeed, they will be doing remarkable things. It is important to note that there are road closures today and you are warning people to stay well clear of those roads that are closed to either let emergency services do their job.
Absolutely. So there is a number of closures in place, and the thing I'd really like to emphasise is that staying away from these areas is really important to enable the fire service to be able to access water so they can do their job.
Douglas Marshall is the Rural Chief Principal Fire Officer for the Selwyn area. He joined me now. What is the very latest? What do we need to tell the residents this morning?
Best job is to get this area in Governor's Bay sorted. We've got 9 trucks, tankers, appliances, that type of thing, with about 40 firefighters over there just giving immediate house protection.
This is News Talk ZB Breaking News.
We go now to Chris Lynch, News Talk ZB announcer. Chris, good afternoon.
Good afternoon, Kerry. Well, we can update that figure to nearly 80,000 homes, according to News Talk ZB's Christchurch newsroom. Orion expects the power hopefully to be on by about 5 o'clock this evening. Now, there's no official word on why the power cuts have happened, but one could imagine it is fire-related. There are plenty of people emailing me and contacting me saying that there are power lines that could be on fire on the Christchurch Port Hills. What I understand as well, that there are shopping centres across the city have had to evacuate because of the power cut. It is causing, particularly on the eastern suburbs of Christchurch, and what we understand is that the power has affected most major intersections on Christchurch's eastern suburbs.
We cross now to Christchurch and News Talk ZB Christchurch host Chris Lynch for the latest on the Christchurch fire.
Good afternoon. Prime Minister Bill English and Defence Minister Gerry Brownlee, they are in the skies as we go to air this afternoon. They're taking in the devastation around the Port Hills, the fire from above. They're in the air at the moment. They are expected to hold a media conference when they return.
More and more people are being evacuated.
Indeed. A lot of these people who are being evacuated, they are self-evacuating. That's due to the fact that they feel uncomfortable with the level of smoke in the Port Hills. But it's more a case of people are being told, I mean, the official word really is from Civil Defence, if you feel uneasy, well, don't wait for the knock on the door. Mm. It may never happen. Just go.
In Christchurch, News Talk ZB host Chris Lynch is back with us. Hi, Chris.
So, good afternoon.
Well, what's the latest? Let's talk about the winds first. Are they strengthening? Because I think they were meant to get up to about 45 k's.
Yes, that's a concern, Larry. I've just been outside. The winds could be described as blustery. And I think it's important to note for residents, because we can't see much of the smoke on the Port Hills, those dramatic photos we've been seeing all morning, the smoke seems to have gone away, but that's only because the wind has changed. It's fair to say this fire is not contained. It is not under control. They're literally just trying to steer it away from homes. To give you some perspective on the size of this fire, Larry, latest reports are that at least 1,800 hectares of fire, it is spread now to the harbour side of the Sugarloaf. There are 14 helicopters in the air, 3 planes. Some are saying, why aren't there more in the air? Well, there are very strict civil aviation rules. Well, very sad news to report. You'll know this by now. If you don't, the helicopter pilot who died helping fight the Port Hills fire near Christchurch yesterday was an ex-SAS serviceman who had been injured in battle. The Waimakariri local, David Askin, just 38 years of age, he was killed in this chopper crash near the Sugarloaf car park just after 2 p.m. Police confirmed his name this morning.
Chris Lynch is in Christchurch and Chris is back with us. Chris, what can you tell us about fighting the fires right now? Because we've just heard the fire officers say, well, they've been stood down, but they can choose to work on. Are they working on?
They certainly are, Larry. I've just been checking outside the studio windows here and I can see multiple helicopters, which I guess is testament to these heroes, frankly. And as reported earlier, you would have heard the rural fire officer, Douglas Marshall. He did say that all the helicopters have been stood down. down, but the pilots, they can choose to still fly if they wish, and they certainly are doing that right now. And I guess what Douglas was also saying is he kind of respects, and I guess we all do, respects the pilots who are still in the air and their decision, and it's probably what their downed companion would have wanted.
We're going to go to our News Talk ZB announcer, Chris Lynch.
Good evening, Mike.
You're down in the Big Smoke, aren't you?
Yeah, I'm located in central Christchurch on the top floor of an apartment complex, and boy did I feel it. It was nothing I've ever experienced before in terms of the different motion this earthquake happened. I think many people will testify to this. No doubt you've had many calls already.
Yep.
It was a quake where you felt just off balance no matter what you tried to do or where you tried to escape.
Woken pretty violently this morning, were you?
I wouldn't call it violent, but Rachel, this was different. Christchurch people, we are used to earthquakes. We're used to the occasional judder in the night just to remind us all that Mother Nature still wants to peck us out and remind us all that she's the centre of attention. But this one was different.
C. We've woken to the news this morning that a magnitude 7.5 earthquake has struck the city near the city of Christchurch in New Zealand. What's interesting is we have an entire business delegation from Canberra there at our sister city in Wellington, the national capital. A little earlier in the program, we caught up with Chris Lynch from News Talk ZB.
We're getting reports further in North Canterbury, in Kaikoura. We still don't know the situation because it's quite an isolated town. So we don't know just how bad the damage is, but I can sadly confirm this morning that at least two people have died.
Chris Lynch standing by, our Christchurch man. Chris, what do you know?
We're getting information coming through all the time from the Ministry of Civil Defence. They say now, and I quote, a tsunami is possible. Anyone near the east coast of the South Island should move to higher ground. And they say, during a tsunami warning, move immediately to the nearest higher ground. Do not go sightseeing.
This is a News Talk ZB developing story.
The very latest is communication is still limited, but it's thought that Kaikoura has taken much of the brunt of the massive 7.5 earthquake. What we do know, at least two people have been confirmed dead. Hamish Dobby is the Hiranui Council boss.
We're getting a fair few reports of damage coming in, Chris.
Joining us now is Associate Civil Defence Minister Gerry Brownlee. What do you know, Minister?
They do have some injuries, but it would appear that they're not too life-threatening.
Matt, you were in New Brighton, you heard the sirens, and so you and your family left, right?
We've left before the sirens, just we had a daughter in a wheelchair, so people said to start going, so we got out a bit earlier than everyone else.
You came home to find what?
Came home about 6:30 and pulled up the drive and noticed my work truck was gone. Come in and the whole house was pretty much tipped upside down, and the buggers had stolen TVs, kids' gaming consoles, iPads. Probably the worst thing was my daughter's FM system that's tuned into her hearing aids.
Your youngest daughter has muscular dystrophy.
Correct, yep.
I'm so sorry to hear this, Matt.
Yeah, just feel invaded, eh, really.
Tim, good morning to you.
Just wanted to say big thumbs up for Talkback after the earthquake. Great job.
Thank you. And I think it's very important to keep the community really connected through the power of Talkback Radio.
It was bloody magic.
David, good morning.
You were doing a phenomenal job, I got to say.
Thank you.
Honestly, mate, you're just a legend.
Now I'm going to let you know exactly what you need to know, courtesy of the Canterbury Civil Defence Emergency Management Group. This was issued just moments ago. It is the very latest information. What we have is the earthquake by now, but we know that Kaiapoi and other towns have been essentially cut off with the State Highway 1 road and rail tunnels blocked by slips. Tsunami warnings for the entire east coast of New Zealand have now been lifted, but people living on the coast are being warned to stay away from beaches and shorelines for the next few hours. Damage in Christchurch's CBD appears to be minimal, although building assessments are still being carried out as we go to air. Earthquake damage has closed State Highway 1 north of Waiputa heading to Picton and State Highway 7, Waiputa to Springs Junction and State Highway 7A to Hamner Springs. The New Zealand Transport Agency is asking motorists to avoid travel on these roads in the meantime, and you can find out more by heading to their website. Well, before we leave you this afternoon, I just want to express my sincere gratitude and thanks and praise to the men and women who have risked their lives to save property, to save people, to save animals, and to make sure that all of the city is safe. You are our heroes, and we thank you. The news is next.